So everyone, are you ready for our first classes here at Hogwarts?
I sure am, Callum. I'm doing potions as my first lesson. I am quite good at science, so I think I should do a great job of it.
I'm doing a dueling lesson, and I think I will most likely ace it given I am trained at combat.
I hope you lot have a great time.
Is something wrong, Holly? You don't seem your usual cheerful self.
Don't worry about me, just go about your day.
It's fine, Harley, you can tell us. We're your friends, and it's our job to listen to whatever worries you have and put it right. Honestly, we won't judge you or anything.
Alright, I'll tell you, don't get me wrong, I love being in Slytherin, but there are a lot of bad people in this house. I mean, the Legion of Malik, the Alanostiums and the DMC Troublemakers are all in Slytherin. Luckily there are some good Slytherins like myself and Kim Woodburn, but the issue is, the evil ones will likely end up losing a lot of points due to their abysmal behavior, and the chances are, we will probably end up with no points left, and we will have no chance of winning the House Cup.
Yeah, I totally get where you are going with that. There are indeed a lot of bad people in our house, and the chances are they will probably bleed the house glass dry within a month.
The chances of those vile troublemakers gaining any points are almost zero. If nothing is done, we will never win the House Cup at all.
Please tell us you have a solution to this issue, Callum. I want Slytherin to have a chance of winning the House Cup without those criminals interfering.
Actually, I do have an idea.
Really? What is it?
In the DMC primary school, Amanda Stenner kept gaining points, but Luke Stenner kept misbehaving and making their house lose them. But luckily, Mr. Peppermint stepped in and split her and Luke's house points. That way then, if Luke lost points by misbehaving, it wouldn't affect the points that Amanda earned. Luke ended up with no points left, but Amanda still has a lot of points. I think we should ask Dumbledore to do the same thing. That way then, if the bad Slytherins lose points, it won't affect the points that the good ones earn.
That actually sounds like a brilliant idea. It's unlikely that the bad Slytherins will gain any points but constantly lose them, but if us good Slytherins' points are separated from the bad ones, we will still have a chance of winning the House Cup.
I agree with Harley, I think that should definitely be the case. Obviously you will have to speak to Dumbledore and Snape about the idea, but I don't think they will say no to that.
Okay, I will go and arrange a meeting with them.
So Callum and Harleen, what do you wish to discuss with us?
My friend Harley was worried about the bad Slytherins constantly losing points by misbehaving and ruining any chance of Slytherin winning the House Cup. It doesn't seem fair that the good Slytherins gain points only for the bad ones to keep losing them. All members of the Legion of Malak, the Alanastiums, and the DMC Troublemakers are in Slytherin, and it's highly unlikely they will gain any points and will almost certainly lose a lot of them.
Knowing how badly those people behave, it's likely that they will drain the Slytherin house glass empty. I may be evil in the DC universe, but I am good here in the land of beyond. So please, if it's possible, could you maybe split the good Slytherins and the bad ones' points into two separate sections? That way then, if the bad ones lose points, it doesn't affect the points that the good ones like myself earn.
To be honest, they do have a valid point. As Callum said, it's unlikely that the bad Slytherins will gain any points. In fact, the chances are almost 0%. Slytherin is at risk of ending up in a point zero situation if nothing is done, so I think we should definitely split the Slytherin house glass into two different sections, so that the good Slytherins don't miss out on a chance to win the House Cup.
You're right, Severus, I think we should definitely grant them their request. Okay, you two, as you wish, I will split the Slytherin house glass into two different sections. The bad Slytherins like the Legion of Malak, the Alanastiums, the Reapers, and the DMC Troublemakers will have one section, whereas the good Slytherins will have the other. The bad ones will likely end up with no points in their side of the house glass, but the good ones will have a high amount of points in theirs, and they still have a fighting chance.
Wow, thanks, Professor. Words cannot even begin to describe how grateful I am.
It's no problem, Harleen. We always do all we can to take care of our students.
Now you two had best head off to class. The last thing you want is to lose points due to tardiness.
Would anyone like to tell me what the incantation for the light charm is? so I see that Miss Blossom is willing to answer that.
The incantation to the light casting charm is Lumos, whereas the incantation to the wand extinguishing charm is Nox.
Nox? How about you go and knock it on the head? And why are we in here being taught by some midget? Hey Shorty, go and fuck a lamp post.
You don't ever speak to your professor like that, Miss Storm. That's 20 points from your side of the Slytherin house glass. As for you, Miss Blossom, that's 20 points to your side of the Slytherin house glass for not only telling me the incantation of the one lighting charm, but the one extinguishing charm as well.
Side of the Slytherin house glass? What are you talking about?
Do you wish for me to explain that, Mr. Williams?
Okay, sure.
Professor Dumbledore has split the Slytherin house glass into two separate sections, one for the good Slytherins, and the other for the bad ones. That way then, whenever the bad Slytherins lose points by misbehaving, it doesn't affect the points that the good ones earn.
So you mean, those goody two-shoes get to keep all their points? That is just retarded.
Well, Miss Storm, we couldn't risk Slytherin House ending up in a point zero situation, so it had to be done. And you have just become the owner of a product called Detention for your rudeness.
You know what? Fuck this. I am going to murder that pipsqueak if it's the last thing I do.
Hey, you leave Professor Flitwick alone.
Avada Kedavra.
Expelliarmus.
Uncle Reaper will hear about this.
Are you okay, Professor?
Thanks for saving me, Miss Blossom. Miss Storm was about to shoot that nasty killing curse at me. It's a good thing you stopped her when you did. I am quite adept at magic, but as we know, the shield charm cannot stop an unforgivable curse. I'm rewarding you 100 points to your side of Slytherin for saving my life. But I probably won't be saying your side of Slytherin for much longer, as the chances are, the bad Slytherins will bleed their side of the glass dry. It's a good thing Professor Dumbledore split the good and bad Slytherins' points, or the whole house would soon have no points left.
Should we continue with the lesson?
To be honest, Mr. Neeves, I am in a state of shock, so I think I will dismiss the class for now. Let's just go to the Three Broomsticks and have a butter beer. Hopefully that should help us get our minds back in order.
Good idea, Professor. And I will be sure to tell Death a Hate Master about what Amiira did so that she can be punished.
We'll worry about that later. Right now let's just go to the Three Broomsticks and have a nice butter beer.